Hank Williams Road.
Okay, so this is like take two of the J-Files 3 because I'm an idiot and can't hit the record button for some stupid reason. Anyway, some of the things we were talking about earlier was there was a Hank... there's a Hank Williams museum, and we drove past it. We could have gone to it, but it's 2 o'clock in the morning, and Elijah didn't want to go knock on the door of Hank Williams.
It's 2:30, and they said they were closed. So.
Anyways, I would have worn my my 10-gallon hat and my shit kickers for that. So, yeah. Anyways, another thing we were talking about in the car was there was a Hall & Oates song that was on earlier. And it was from the 500 Days of Summer soundtrack. And the first thing that jumped in my head was like any 80s movie, like Tootsie or Big or whatever. That's like the first thing because that was the time frame when it came out. And which is weird, makes me feel old because, a kid nowadays would say that's from 500 Days of Summer. And I would just shake my head in despair and just go hide in my corner with my old self or something like that. But then, remember kids, the 80s and the 90s were the best generations. I don't know. We'll just say that. But then,
not for comics, though.
I don't know. The 90s for comics was pretty awesome.
It was, but it's not considered one of the better decades.
I don't know. But that's when I started getting really interested in it.
Well, that's when I got into it.
Yeah. The whole X-Men time frame.
Well, only because of X-Men. League.
So that totally made me a Marvel guy for a lots of years. And then the other thing that was funny that we were talking about was we drove by a freeway that was going to Georgiana, but we're already in the state of Georgia, so I find that kind of bizarre.
105 mile marker, 2:30 a.m., 39 degrees.
Woo! Yeah, he says it like he's a pilot.
You're right.
This is great. You're right. So, to explain this to people who are watching this, apparently, as pilots, is this what it is?
When you know that's driving.
Whatever. So, if he says clear left, it means he's checked his left-hand side and it's okay to go.
And it'd be nice if the co-pilot were to check his right and say clear right. And I would know to either turn left or turn right, or that's A-okay. So, that's just the logic behind it. I mean, it just works out, you know. If you're riding shotgun, you should be an active participant in navigation, period.
I'm too busy playing with my tablet, making videos, and typing on his iPhone for his videos and stuff like that. So, I don't know. I'm really bad at this job. Anyway, so this is Jeremiah and Elijah signing out.